In his book, Cialdini states that catastrophic events happened in serials. If an airplane crashes, the chance that a week later another airplane will crash rises. This is based on much research, which I will address later. Although the book was published more than 30 years ago, if we look at events from recent years, we can find that it is still relevant, and we can identify some disasters that occurred in chains. Let's take an example. In March 2019, the Ethiopian Airlines Boeing Max 737 airplane, which took off from Addis Ababa to Jomo Kenyatta, crashed. 4.5 months earlier, in October 2018, the same airplane model of Lyon Air also crashed, a second crash in a period less than 6 months of the same exact model. In February 2020, a Turkish airline, Pegasus Boeing 737, collided with a wall after landing at Istanbul Airport and was completely broken. During the month leading up to the event, another airplane of the same model and the same airline company slipped on the same runway at the exact same airport. Again, the same catastrophic event in almost a month. According to Cialdini, when there is an airplane crash or a car accident, other major events are still taking place which we do not hear about, since these airplanes are private or military airplanes. What you see is a graph showing the increase in accidents after the first incident of private airplanes, passenger airplanes, and road accidents. This is not only relevant for airplane crashes, but accidents in general. For example, in June 2020, 20,000 tons of oil spilled into the river in Siberia. It was the biggest oil spill disaster in human history. 2 months after that, more than 1,000 tons of oil leaked from a Japanese ship to Mauritius shores, causing irreversible damage. Less than 6 months later, and a similar incident happened on the shores of Israel. Again, three similar major incidents occurred, one following the other. It is important to note that the previous massive leak occurred in the late 1980s at the coast of Alaska, and when that happened again, it was a sequence of three similar incidents. In August 2020, Beirut Airport exploded, an event which shocked the Arab world and grabbed all the headlines in the media. In 2021, Dubai faces an explosion at its port, although on a smaller scale. But again, for years, no such catastrophic event has happened, and when it did, two similar cases followed. Another port explosion, and again, in an Arab country. And there are many more examples. So what exactly makes it happen? In trying to figure it out, I searched for studies discussing this subject, and was shocked by what I found. David Phillips from the University of California found that this actually happens due to the publication of the event and not because of the event itself. He investigated the suicide statistics in the United States and found that if there was a suicide case published in the press on the main page, it was followed with an increase of 58 persons committing suicide, a higher rate than the annual average. This only happened in areas where the case has been published. The more attention and publicity that was given to the first event, the more it led to an increase in the number of subsequent cases. These are people who were completely sane and are not diagnosed with mental illness. He also found that if an elderly driver had an accident in a particular area and it was published along with grabbing the headlines, more accidents occurred among the same type of drivers. If the accident involved a 30-year-old driver, then more similar fatal accidents occurred among 30-year-old drivers. If a crime in which one person died was published, it will lead to more crimes in which one person will die. If there was a crime in which more than one person died, then there will be more cases that will cause the death of more than one person. Usually, they will be similar to the first crime. A similar crime that happens to people with similar characteristics of the first person, whether it's a man or a woman, his or her skin color, age group, and more. What's most amazing is that it only happens in places where the event was published. If in a certain area a similar event happened and was not published, there will be no more cases in that area. If the event appeared more in the headlines and received more media prominence, the chances of a similar case happening increased when comparing such an event that was not given media exposure. Or on the other hand, if it was published on the second page or in the middle of the newspaper. In general, watching tragic events on television can lead to a large number of suicides and self-harm. For example, a study conducted in the UK after the death of Princess Diana shows that such an event may influence suicidal and self-harm behavior. The number of suicide cases in England following the death of the princess was analyzed and compared to previous years. The results show that 4 weeks after the funeral, the suicide rate in England increased by 17% compared to previous years. Most of them were women close to the princess's age. What is also interesting, similar to the findings of the previous study, the women who committed suicide were mentally stable but chose to end their lives. Researchers have tried to give the phenomenon a few explanations. What they found to be most relevant was social proof. A topic that in itself is worth a video, but in short, in a certain situation where we are not sure how to behave, we tend to intake information and imitate someone else similar to us. There is tremendous influence of others on our behavior. Therefore, it is highly important to pay attention to what and to whom we are exposed. And in general, watching and consuming loads of news can affect us negatively, causing passive behavior and loss of hope. There is even a name for it, mean world syndrome, a term imprinted by media researcher George Gerbner, which shows that people who watch more news will experience the world as crueler and more dangerous compared to people living in similar environment and consume less news. Now, I'm not saying that we shouldn't be up to date on what is happening around us, but we need to pay attention to the importance we give to it in our daily lives. Because such information gets into our brains and affects us without even being aware of it. Who knows, perhaps Pegasus pilot could have taken control over the airplane, but the thought of a crash was pre-implanted in his mind and was an option because he had just heard it happen to his colleague a month earlier. Well, I will end the video with an optimistic point of view and tell you that it works the other way around too. If we see more successful people similar to us, then we are more inclined to succeed. It is generally said that when information is released in the universe, it will be easier for us to perceive it once we are aware it is possible. Lastly, I want to share with you the story of Roger Bannister, who broke a world record in 1954 by finishing a mile run in less than 4 minutes. Up until then, scientists and physicians have stated that the human body is unable to do so. This was only until Roger managed to break this barrier. What is fascinating is that from this point on and up until today, more than 20,000 people, including high school students, have done it. What has changed that has made so many people succeed in doing this? Well, I think you know the answer. They just broke the mental barrier in their mind. When they got on the track, they realized that it is not impossible, that someone else has already done it, so they can do it too. So, my friends, surround yourself with positive people and positive things. It affects you more than you could imagine. If you like this video, do not forget to hit like and subscribe. Share it with friends so they could enlighten too. Thanks, and see you soon!